What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. And I decided to turn on the face cam, and I'm going to go over what weapons I have and don't have, camos, all that in Black Ops 3. But I wanted to talk to you guys for a few minutes about some big things that are coming up in the world of Call of Duty and kind of give you an update on what's going on with me, what's going on with the channel, you guys, all that good stuff. It's probably echoey because the mic is way over here and I've got the live stream set up. That's how I'm recording this, but hopefully you guys can bear with me. So, first things first, okay? We're going to talk about me playing Call of Duty World War II in a minute, connecting to online service. I'm doing this live. We're going to check out some of my Black Ops 3 stuff. I got the Galil the other day. But before we talk about COD World War II, I wanted to let you guys know that Charlie Intel put out a tweet, there we go, stating that, well, it's not confirmed, but usually if it gets to Charlie Intel, then there's a good chance that it's real, that Modern Warfare Remastered could be available standalone come, I think it was June 20th for PlayStation 4 and July 20th for Xbox One. It's a month behind, obviously, and they've got pictures up. I'll put a link in the description if you guys want to check it out. If you are one of the people that decided not to get Infinite Warfare because you didn't want to play the game, you only wanted it for Modern Warfare Remastered, but you decided to hold out in hopes you could get Modern Warfare Remastered standalone, this is for you. If it ends up being true, I know there's some people out there that just, they would not buy Infinite Warfare. They didn't want anything to do with it, and they didn't get to enjoy Modern Warfare Remastered because the only possible way to get it was via buying it bundled with Infinite Warfare. So if this ends up being true, this is for all of you guys to be able to, to be able to play it, get it alone. So I want to know in the comment section, are you going to be getting Modern Warfare Remastered standalone if it's available? Most of you probably already have it, but I know there's a few out there that just held fast and said no. So I unlocked the Galil the other day, but I wanted to go over the weapons I don't have as we do this live commentary, just chill live commentary. I wanted to update you guys on Modern Warfare Remastered. Before we talk about COD World War II, I did want to say a huge shout out. I don't have the Peacekeeper. I don't know what that thing is. The M16, I never got the M16, so there's three assault rifles right there that I did not get. I did get the Galil, but I didn't get that. So we'll check some machine guns in a second. So, big shout out to everybody on my notification squad. Every video now, I put up this thing across the screen for you guys. It says, turn on notifications, because YouTube does not send out videos to the sub box, to everybody. They never have, they never will. So it's on me to communicate with you guys and grow my notification squad. If you don't know what that is the people that get a notification when my video or live stream goes live. They're the notification squad. Most of them will like a comment that I put, or they'll tweet at me saying, show me a picture, saying they're notification squad. It's growing every day. So I want to say a big shout out to you guys. And the channel's doing really well. And it's because of you guys. A lot of you are enjoying the video game top 10 at night. We do a different video game oriented top 10 every night. And there's just some of those that are just popping off. So thank you for all that. And the Call of Duty videos during the day are doing really, really well as well. So I wanted to give you guys a big thank you. Kind of me personally, you guys. I don't do a lot of vlogs anymore or do personal commentaries. So I wanted to let you guys know. Let's look really quick at the SMGs. Okay, we never got the nail gun. We never got whatever that thing is. We never got the PPSH. We don't have the AK-74U. So three assault rifles and four SMGs that I've never got to experience in Black Ops 3. I have all the shotguns. Look at that. Got the Banshee. So nothing in shotguns. And I did get the Ajax. So shotguns and LMGs, I got everything. But the important categories like assault rifle and submachine gun, I didn't get anything. And then I don't have the new whatever that assault rifle is. We're going to look at secondaries here in a second. That's where it's all about. But now I want to talk with you guys about how maybe I'm going to be able to meet a couple of you guys. I have not been to an event in a year and a half, maybe longer. No, I don't know. A year, like an actual event. I've been to capture events in the past and stuff, but an actual event, like E3 or an MLG event or anything, it's been a long, long time. And I am going to be flying out to LA for E3. I will be at E3 to play Call of Duty World War II. And you may say, well, that's great for you. What about me? Well, it's open to the public. Which means if you are going to E3, which is also open to the public, so not only is Call of Duty World War II multiplayer going to be available to everybody, not just me, everybody, but E3, I believe, is open to the public this year. So it's going to be crazy. It's going to be nuts. But if you're lucky enough to get there, you can get your hands on Call of Duty World War II multiplayer right alongside me. So follow me on Twitter, because I'm definitely going to tweet out and stuff when I'm at the event, because I would love to interact with you guys. I mean, that was one of the biggest positives for me when I was running TK or going to MLG events or anything like that. COD Champs, it was meeting you guys. Seriously, when we went to COD Champs last year, I met so many of you. So many of you. It was overwhelming and humbling that many people support my channel and are at these events and want to talk. So hopefully I'll get to meet you guys if you're there. I will definitely be there, and I want to meet as many people as I can that follow me, support the channel, so on and so forth. So I'm going to be playing Call of Duty World War II. I don't know what to expect. I really don't, because we've heard on the campaign that you can't heal yourself. You don't self-heal. You have to call a medic, just like you would have done on the front line if you were in the war, okay? And then with ammo, you can't just pick ammo. These are things that we're so used to. We just run around, pick up ammo, we self-heal, and we get back in the fight. Now you can't pick up ammo. You have to borrow ammo off of your squad mates. So I don't think that's going to transition over to multiplayer. I don't see how it could. But there's so many questions up in the air. Let me know in the comment section, what is your biggest question or fear, something, concern about Call of Duty World War II multiplayer? Don't say supply drops, because they're coming. Regardless if you like it or not, they're going to be there. So give me something else. Let's look at the pistols really quick. There's the M1911 that we don't have. Launchers, we have all the launchers. Special, we don't have that thingy. And we never got that. And the ballistic knife, isn't it? So here's where the bread and butter is for what I never got. You ready? I got the wrench, the brass knuckles, iron gem, MVP knife. I got a lot of them. Don't get me wrong. I just got the nunchucks the other day. Path of Sorrows, Ace of Spades. And then we get into so many ones I didn't get. I never got that thing. I never got that thing. That. It goes on. What is that? Cattle prod? On. I never got the mannequin arm. That thing is really cool. It reminds me of something out of Star Trek. And there. I never got any of those. What is that? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 or 9. At 3 assault rifles, 4 SMGs, I probably have 20 DLC items that I've never got to play with. Come on, Treyarch. We need to give everybody all of these for free. Yeah. Anyway, big shout out to every one of you that comes out to the live streams. I live stream 4 or 5 times a week now on this very channel. Shout out to everybody that supports the COD videos, supports the top 10s in the evening. The channel is growing. I've got that. I'm about to... It was funny because I went from 1.1 million subscribers, and it took me like 2 years to get to 1.3. And now we're from 1.3, we're getting close to 1.5. So there's some momentum, got that breath of fresh air, if you will, got that hype. I don't know, maybe it's because Boots on the Ground is coming, I don't know, but I appreciate every single one of you. And that's pretty much it, guys. I don't get around to doing personal vlogs as much on this channel as I used to. I don't know. I don't know why. It's not anything personal, or I don't want to commute. I don't know. I don't know. I have no idea. But when I do get on here and talk to you guys like this, I get really, really thankful and humble, emotional. I'm a sensitive dude, I guess. But I do appreciate you guys more than you probably will ever know. I'm heading to Vegas in a couple days. If you guys would like to see some kind of Vegas vlog, maybe I could do that. I don't know. It's not for work. It is actually rarely for pleasure only, which is kind of crazy, but maybe I could do some kind of vlog if you guys want me to, or do maybe even a live stream from my iPhone. I can live stream straight on my channel. Maybe live stream. We've got a really, really nice penthouse suite type thing at the, I don't even remember where we're at. We're somewhere. We're somewhere there. We've got something nice. I'll have to go look, but we're going with a couple other couples and friends and stuff, but it's gonna be a blast. And maybe I'll do I don't know. I do all kinds of stuff on Instagram. I have like my Instagram where you do the, whatever it's called, the daily pictures at the top. I don't remember. I do that every day. So make sure you follow me there. And I'm super active on Twitter as always. But yeah, that's it. Call of Duty World War II, man. The hype is just beginning. I mean, it really, really is. As soon as we get to see multiplayer, get our hands on it, then we can really, really kind of get an idea of what we're in store for. And if it's going to meet our expectations of what we're actually looking for, because there's so many questions. that need answered. A lot of minute details that we need answers to. So in the comment section, once again, tell me your biggest concern for Call of Duty World War II multiplayer. What do you think has to happen to make sure it's what everybody wants? Hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I'll see you later.